Mark Hiscock is going to join me on this. This is brand new. Hope you like it. It's called Go Away, Dwight and Cathy. Go away, Dwight and Cathy. What did our poor ever do to you? We can barely pay the rent now. We gotta pay to live here too. What is perfect? We hate our children. And you can't dumb us. Go away, Dwight and Cathy. We don't want your kind. Take your levy, your cuts, and your taxes. Stick them up your $900 behind. Newfoundland and Labrador, fight to see it come true. Oh, go away, Dwight and Cathy. We're not having 4 years of you.
Thank you. Labrador is a town hall meeting for all the public, Thursday coming, 7 o'clock to 9 o'clock at the Lantern in St. John. So if you want to add your piece to what we're saying, come join us on Thursday and we'll have a great old chat.
Who here is leaving?
No!
I'm not leaving. Nobody has to leave, but that's not the indicator that we got from the recent budget. Are you angry?
Yes!
Are you angry?
Yes!
And I think everybody has a right to be. I'm the proud president of the Fish, Food, and Allied Workers UNIFOR. We have members in every single community in this province, and they've been hammered by this budget. So we shouldn't have to do more consultations, but I'm looking out here. Hold up the signs, everybody. I'm doing some consultations here. Is the solution to close libraries?
No!
I see the budget is too heavy. Get rid of the levy. So we do have to hang our heads in shame after this budget. We do have different choices. It's not just the levy, but the levy is indicative of the mentality, we believe, of this current government. They really had to start listening to thousands and thousands of people here today and everyone else in our province. A blanket of austerity is not the answer. We need something that gives hope. Hope for our young people. So hope that we have a future in the province. Because it's not about leaving. We never saw any hope whatsoever in this recent budget. So we need investment, and we need a future that has good jobs for everybody here in the province. So I'm glad that everybody came out today.
Yeah.
Let's hear it for democracy. Yeah. Let's hear your voice. And the FFAW and all the members, like I said, all the Newfoundland and Labrador, there's thousands here today, but there's thousands more in spirit, doing what they do, working in their communities, raising their families across the province. So thanks, everybody. This is just a start, unless our government listens and deals with the problems. So speak up, folks. Solidarity.
Yeah, here, here.
Labrador Coalition of Pensioners, Seniors, and Retirees. I have spent the last 9 days traveling across this island, holding 2 town hall meetings per day, talking to seniors, pensioners, and anybody who would like to come to those town hall meetings, and believe you me, they did turn out. I saw at those meetings 3 different things. I saw fear on everybody's face. I saw frustration as to what was happening and a real fear of what was going to happen in the future. The people who came there came to get information on what was going to happen to them. And I tell you, the picture isn't very rosy. We had a number of them who said that they had plans now to move out of this province because they couldn't afford to live here any longer and pay their rent and all other things and go to their families and extended families somewhere on the mainland. I hope that they'll live out their days in peace and dignity. Further to that, I saw an amount of frustration that's coming out of those people because of the silence of the politicians who they elected.
Yeah.
Many of them told me that they have written many, many newsletters, emails and written letters, sent them a registered mail and everything else to those members of the Liberal caucus, and they have received no reply. And they said, is there anywhere we can get a list of the debt benefits to see if they all passed away since the election? Brothers and sisters, we heard Jerry Earle this morning speak of a few people, and I'll just give you an example of one. We were in Grand Falls having a meeting, and we were getting ready to lay out some materials which we had, and there was this little lady came in, and my partner who was with me at the time, he said, Ralph, he said, that lady is crying, go down. So I went down and I talked to her. And I said, what's wrong? And she said, I'm 76 years old. I am a cancer survivor. They now think that I'm out of remission. And she said, I just got off the phone with my son and I've called him 6 times since yesterday, wondering what I should do. And she said, the conclusion that I've come to that I'm going to have to leave this town that I lived in for the last 79 years and go to the mainland and get and try to live out up there and get the proper treatment. Brothers and sisters, this is what we heard as we went across the island. We as a coalition of seniors, pensioners and retirees offer you our support in any way, shape or form that we can give it to you in the continued fight to get this overturned and hopefully get this government out of office. Yes. Thank you.
This is amazing. Look at all these people here. My name is Alex Norton, and I'm with the Canadian Federation of Students. We represent all public post-secondary students in this province, all 28,000 students. Students, who, like many of you, have been hit very hard by this budget. Students who have fought tirelessly for years for a needs-based grants program, only to have it ripped away from us. Students that came here for a more affordable education and now are faced with impending tuition fee increases. Students who already work 2 or 3 jobs just to make ends meet. Over the last few weeks, we have heard a lot of talk from this government about how they're making tough decisions. Well, let me tell you something about tough decisions, Mr. Ball. A tough decision is when you have to choose between buying textbooks or buying groceries. A tough decision is when you have to choose between paying your tuition fees or paying the light bill. A tough decision is choosing to move to the mainland in order to get a job to start paying off your student debt instead of staying at home here in Newfoundland and Labrador. While the Liberals might lose a few nights' sleep over their so-called tough decisions, it's the most vulnerable people of our province who stand to lose the most. It's the young mother at CNA who has to drop out because she can't afford to go to school and pay for childcare. It's the student in Bonavista Vista who can't afford to move to St. John's to get a post-secondary education. It's the international student that will be forced to go back to their home country with no accreditations because they can't afford to pay the rising tuition fee costs. These are the people that will suffer the most under the Liberal slash and burn budget. These are the people that will be driven away from this province at a time when we need them the most. The decision to move away in order to pay down student debt is one that young people in this province know all too well, and the Liberals' cuts to the needs-based grants program will only drive more of us away. saddling young people with massive debt is not the way to build a stronger future. Premier Ball, do you think for one moment that you can deny a generation of Newfoundlanders and Labradorians a fair shot at a future? If you think your actions will stop us from mobilizing and fighting back, well, you're wrong! Building. Woo! That fight will be won around our kitchen tables, in our classrooms, in our workplaces, and on the streets. Yeah. I know this fight won't be easy, but looking at all of you here today gives me hope. Because the people of this province, we know the people of this province won't stop, and we know the people, we will not let ourselves be ignored.
No!
Today we're sending a very strong message to this government. This is just the beginning.
Has confidence
confidence in the professionalism of teachers to make it work. Well, that is disrespectful, because for that to work, teachers need the resources. They need the specialists, they need the people. Now, if there's one thing we as teachers know, is how do you deal with failure? Well, we have a good solution for that. It's in our evaluation policy. It's called a do-over. So we're calling on Premier Ball, Minister Bennett, and Mr. Kirby to do a do-over on this budget.
Much to fight for in our healthcare system.
because it's my belief that the big shoe around healthcare will come in the fall, and we will need to stand together again and again and again to fight for the healthcare system we want and we deserve.
Blundon, I'm Secretary Treasurer of the Federation of Labor and Secretary Treasurer of Labor. It's a beautiful warm day, and I can only hazard a guess it's because of all the hot air blowing from the Confederation.
Hey, Shocking.
This government has came to power on a promise of a stronger tomorrow. But the only thing that I find stronger is a stench of a government that's gone rotten to its very core. Dishonor. What kind of government, I'd ask you, who would come to power and bring in a budget that's projecting in its own documents that thousands and thousands and thousands of Newfoundlanders and Labradorians to leave the province over the next 4 years? What kind of a government, I'd ask you, would come to power and bring in a budget that projects that our unemployment rate to grow close to 20%? Thousands upon tens of thousands of jobs gone from this province. I'll tell you what kind of government that comes to power and does that is a government who has lost the trust and the confidence in the people. The premier of the province might be able to win his party shape, but I'm telling you one thing, he's not going to whip Newfoundland and Labrador residents into shape anytime soon. If government can find $1.3 billion for now, Court, it can find $1 million for our libraries. If government can find $1.3 billion for libraries, it can find enough money to keep out our valuable services in every single community in Newfoundland and Labrador. And if the Premier himself can find somebody to lead now, Cor, I'm sure that people in Newfoundland and Labrador can find somebody to lead this great province. I suggest to you that it's time for every Liberal NHA, whether he's in cabinet or whether he's in the back benches, to decide whether to stand with the people or against the people.
All right. Here, here.
And if they fail to stand with the people, they do so at their own peril. In closing, I'd like to thank all the people who spoke here today on your behalf, who got forward their stories from every single community in Newfoundland and Labrador. On behalf of their, and on behalf of the speakers, I'd like to thank you for coming out today and raising your opposition to this great Colleen budget. Let us ignore the stench that's coming from the Confederation building and our leaders. Thank you very much for coming.
All right, folks, we're at the end now. We've only got 10 more speakers. I'm only joking. Thanks so much for coming out. One thing that we want to say, again, thank you to all of the organizers, all of the speakers, again, like Brother Bert just said, all of the people who came out today gave up part of their Saturday for today, but today is one day. Today is one event. We have to make sure that we stand united as a people. Write your NHA, write the Premier, call open line, write the local paper. Make sure that this momentum carries forward from today so that they rue every single day that they don't listen to the people of Newfoundland and Labrador. They say cut back.
I'm a Newfoundlander, born and bred, and I'll be one till I die. I'm proud to be an Islander,
and here's the reason why.
I'm free as the wind and the waves that wash the sand. There's no place I would rather be than here in Newfoundland. I spent some time in New York State and I nearly lost my mind. This city life's too fast for me and nobody has the time. Cement and steel and flashing light was all that I could see. It may be good for New York State,
but it's no damn good for me.
I'm a Newfoundlander, born and bred, and I'll be one till I die. I'm proud to be an Islander, and here's the reason why. I'm free as the wind and the waves that wash the sand. There's no place I would rather be than here in Newfoundland. In Montreal, the Frenchmen say that they own Labrador, including Indian Harbor, where we caught a fish before. But if they want to fight for her, I'll surely take a stand.
And they'll regret today they tried to take our Newfoundland.
I'm a Newfoundlander, born and bred, and I'll be one till I die. I'm proud to be an Islander, here's the reason why. I'm free as the wind and the waves that wash the sand. Now something place would rather be than here in Newfoundland. Now that the isle is on our shore, we better take the time
to develop it more carefully, or else we're gonna find what could have been the answer to our poor economy. Has changed our way of living and destroyed our fishery.
I'm born and bred and I'll be one till I die.
Louder! Wash the sand. There's no place I would rather be. One more time.
I'm a Newfoundlander, born and bred, and I'll be one till I die. I'm proud to be an islander. Here's the reason why.
I'm free as the wind and the waves to wash the sand.
There's no place I would rather be than here in Newfoundland.
There's no place I would rather be than here in Newfoundland.
How you doing, Mark?
Man, how you doing?
Good. Finished filming.
Oh, yeah?
Still running here.
Oh, yeah?
Turn the shit off. Got right up me in there, though.